So, what are some of your tips for using BeatStars? Like, how do you get the best out of it? How do you interact with your customers or your fans? And how do you go about collaborating with other people on the platform?
Well, actually, BeatStars is a really friendly platform. I see a lot of people reach out. And even for me, I just really upload what I think would suit best for the actual BeatStars platform. I think there's a lot of different lanes you can go, but I've stuck to a more like simplistic lane. And I see a lot of people like to buy more simple beats, stuff that's like, because, okay, to best describe it is like producers like to hear like very complex beats and different things, but like to the normal rapper's ear, they might not want to rap on something that doesn't have a lot of room on it. So, for instance, I would always try to have the rapper in mind when I'm placing things on BeatStars because I have like, different beats for different ventures. But for all the stuff that I put on BeatStars, I wanted it to be a little bit more simplistic and to just sound good and actually have a good quality mix and different things like that. But for the most part, I'd say that with collaborating and everything, a lot of people reach out, and I see a lot of people sending loops just from DMing me and different things. And I think, just in general, like I try to keep in mind like what I can do to better market myself. And even like Danny was telling me, like even like creating a YouTube page and driving traffic over to the BeatStars page too, which a lot of people use to gain a lot of traction.
Have you found that using YouTube is helping you?
Most definitely. I've been a little bit lazy, I can't lie. I haven't really been uploading as much because I've been really focused right now on just sending out different packs and stuff. And I'm also venturing out into engineering as well. So I'm going to be full-time engineering in January and everything. So to get through that process, I've been just focusing on that. But for the most part, like getting your YouTube page to have actual traffic is a really great idea because how it was explained to me is that, let's say, okay, what you probably want to do is almost have it like a gas station, like, because that's kind of what YouTube is. Like, when you search through, okay, blah, blah type beat, the first thing that pops up is what people are probably going to click on most likely. They're not going to go all the way down to search for your beat. So, how it was best explained is to actually blow up with certain artists that are about to come up. So, for instance, like, let's say, like even Lil Uzi, like that's a great person that people should probably be making tight beats for because he's a new priority at Atlantic. And for instance, like he's not the biggest name in the world, so the YouTube traffic there, you don't have to battle against so many producers actually trying to make tight beats. But you should try to find like a niche place where you can grow with the artist and you can drive all that traffic to your BeatStars page.